So we are back for Champions League knockout round action. The first leg, we were given a little bit of a hiding, but we escaped with an away goal and a 1-1 draw. It's still unlikely that we will qualify for the quarterfinals, but imagine if we did. That's got to be FM21 Redemption. Before we get out there for the game today, it's Patreon update time again, because would you believe it, patron number 2 has joined the channel. Thank you very much, IronBear89. Your generosity is incredible. Hopefully, the boys can reward you by qualifying us for a Champions League quarterfinal spot. However, we've got a little bit of a selection dilemma ahead of this crucial tie. So before we jump into the tactics and show you our dilemmas, we've only played the one game since the 4-0 victory over Lorient in the Cup that set up that final against Grenoble. By the way, we'll just check in on Grenoble, because not only are they a team in the division below us that we're playing in the Cup final, but they're not even having a very good campaign in that division. They're on the cusp of being relegated to France's third tier, so you can already tell we're going to louse that one up in what could be one of our final episodes at Toulouse. However, we've also played a league game since that Lorient victory. It was against Lorient again. This time, we took them on in Ligue 1 and we got ourselves a 2-0 victory. It wasn't a sparkling performance, but we did put out a rotated squad just so that we could rest our key players for the encounter against Valencia tonight. Whether it will work, I'm not sure, because we've still got some suspensions. We've also got some fitness issues, and we're not sure exactly how adventurous to play against a team that we drew with in the first leg, but who wildly outplayed us. So that we escaped from the first leg with a draw is a little bit of a miracle, to be honest. Valencia pulled an XG of above 2. They had 15 shots on target. Our best player on the night was our goalkeeper. And we got very fortunate to get an injury time equaliser. We went out there and played with our most conservative system, our 5-2-3 formation. And even that looked like it was struggling to keep them at bay. So we're not entirely sure what strategy to go with tonight. Over the last few fixtures, we've actually switched up to playing a 4-2-4 formation, and it's been opening teams up pretty successfully. It's what we used against Lorient in the league game that we just played and in the cup game that we played in the last episode. However, as things stand, a 1-1 draw on aggregate is enough to squeeze us into the quarterfinals on away goals. So we're a little bit reticent to be playing a 4-2-4 against a team that's clearly superior to us. So this may well be the wrong call. You're probably already screaming down in the comment section. But we're going to persist with our most cautious of tactics, our 5-2-3. Okay, we're underway with a home team in front of a packed Stade Municipal, and this is going to be a difficult game. You didn't get to see the first leg, but we were overrun. We were very, very fortunate only to be one goal down going into that injury time where we snatched that late equaliser. If we get anything from today's game, I think we're going to have to be relying on us taking what very few chances we will have during the game. But we're in early, and Carver has blasted us in to a 1-0 lead inside 90 seconds. Now, that doesn't necessarily help us, because we would have been going through anyway. And if Valencia now equalise, we're still heading to extra time. But my goodness, I said we might not get many chances in this game, but we've worked an opening. I think it was Chan that sent the ball through to Carbot, and he's lashed one home, proving that maybe it was the right decision to risk him, even though his fitness is not the best. I'm thinking we're going to struggle to get Carbot through the game, and we're going to struggle to get Mallet through a full 90 minutes as well. So if they could make an impact early, That would be very, very helpful. We've got Monet, the artist at the back, thumping it out of play. We're into the highlights again. Here is little Mallet, and he sent Carvot through as a second time, and there wasn't a lot of build-up to that highlight, which usually tells you it's not going to result in a goal, but it has resulted in a corner, and Chan has slung it in, and Nicholas is in, and Mane was lurking at the far post, and Valencia have scrambled it behind, and 20 minutes in, you'd have to say this is a decent start. A second goal to capitalise on this little promising opening might just be enough to deflate Valencia, because I think they are going to come back strong. They've got plenty of players valued over £20 million. Although let's not do ourselves a disservice. We've got Salim Chan in our midfield now. He's valued at over £40 million. So we're no mugs, but we don't have the depth that a squad like Valencia have with a wage budget that's five times what our weekly wage expenditure is. And they have raided us down our right-hand side, and they've got in. And there is the equaliser that we feared. And I think that's the same player that might have got them the goal. In their first leg, they have got in too easily down the right. Maybe that's a fault of only having a wing-back on that side. Although there were opportunities to have won the ball and got it away there. They were not taken. And we've been punished, and now we are back all square. So the away goal that we scored has been wiped out. And actually now Valencia are dominating the match. That's dominating the XG. And we're looking like a team that needs to find some fresh ideas in the second half. We're going to go and tell our boys exactly that. We're also going to assess the fitness of the players that were touch and go as to whether they would even be selected. And we'll see you for the second 45. Okay, we are back underway. We've not made any changes, but we did tell the boys, actually. We gave them a bit of a rough team talk and told them that we weren't happy with their performance, even though underneath the surface, 1-1 with Valencia is not a bad first half, to be honest, but we want to drive them on to do more. We're going to need a goal, otherwise this tie is going to extra time. If Valencia score again, well, we are chasing the game royally. So it's difficult to know whether to stick or twist. And we've raced our way to 62 minutes and not created a thing. And Carvot is starting to look a little bit uneasy out there. So I think it's time for our first change. Okay, back underway. Benny Yeder has come on. He's a striker, but he's okay playing out there on the right-hand side. And at least he's going to have a little bit of freshness in place of the flagging Carvot. And he's been involved and got the ball to Kyrgyzstan. And we've picked it up. It's Salim Chan. It's Barr. He's in. He's not having a good game, Lansana. Barr, that was a great chance. He could not beat the keeper. He's pulling a 6.3, by the way. Not a good performance from him, but he's a danger. He's quick. He's a good dribbler. And he's also helped get Chan in. Unfortunately, we cannot get a chance. Valencia are breaking on us. I think at 75, we might be looking at making another change. Maybe we're going to be taking Lansana Barr off because he is having a pretty poor game. Okay, we've kept one sub off up our sleeve. We've left Chan on because he is our best player. Sturvold wasn't playing well and was struggling for fitness just as much as Chan is. But we are starting to look like a team that is holding on a little bit, and we've got 10 minutes to go to try and force extra time. There is Chan winning the ball back for us, and we've gone over the top and it's not paid off, and we've got to try and win the ball back again. And they're breezing through that midfield again. And I think we might need a little bit of change of formation. I'm feeling like we need maybe a third central midfielder in there just to try and shore things up a little bit. We've got the ball though. We've got Giria Barr, who if we weren't struggling for fitness would be taken off by now. He's going to make this decision for us, isn't he? 10 minutes to go, and Barr has made the kind of tackle that the FM gods throw at you when you're all square in a big game. That changes everything. We're now going to have a look at how we change this ahead of what's going to be a very tough final 10 minutes. Okay, we're underway again. This is going to be a bit of a tricky time for us. We've gone with keeping two in the central midfield, moving Chan as a number 10 just in front of them, with Benny Yedder as the lone front man. It's not an ideal formation, but at least it means that we've now got three players in the centre of the pitch, even if Chan is a little bit more advanced. But we are running on empty, I think, a little bit. We've got tired players all over the pitch, and we've not really created a lot in the second half, aside from that chance that Barr really should have put away. What a miserable evening he has had. And we've got 3 minutes left, and Valencia have the ball. And look at the gaps they've got in that midfield. We need to get over there and win the ball. Labate has done it. Bit of a risky challenge when you're already down to 10. But we've got the ball, and Chan is the man that can make things happen. And here is our left wing back. And that is another great chance. That could have been the late winner that we craved. He stung the palms of the keeper, but should have gone across the keeper and rifled it in. We've got corners coming in now. They've headed it clear. We're going to have another corner. We've got 2 minutes left. Sling one into that near post. Frankie Nick should be there somewhere looking to try and head home. We're playing for time a little bit. We sent it to the far post this time. We pick the ball up. Can we craft a little chance? We can't. The highlight is over, and now we've got a defensive set piece of our own to try and navigate. It's gone all the way across the box. They've got it. Ooh, they've got it right on the edge. Close him down. Don't let him shoot. They've got men over. Oh, Nicholas nearly carried it into his own goal. Let's say that he knew what he was doing, shall we? And we now got extra time to try and navigate. I'm going to go into the tactics and see whether we get an extra substitution for extra time. Though I could be clutching at rather hopeful straws. Okay, extra time is underway. We did get an extra substitute, by the way. And I've done something a bit unconventional. I've moved striker Benny Yedder to be our right wing back, because Kyrgyzstan was playing poorly. That was another one that was very tired, and it's allowed me to bring Larsen Pleem up front. I'm feeling like we could be doing a lot of defending in extra time. And maybe Larsen Pleem might just give us a threat on any counter-attacks that we can fashion. We've got 4 minutes of extra time played. We've headed one clear, and here is the counter-attacking opportunity that we were looking for. And Larsen Pleem has come on for exactly this reason. But we'd hoped that he would be able to stick his chance away, and he hasn't. And I feel like we've had the chances to put this tie to bed, you know. And we've not been able to do it. And now we've had a header flick across the front of the goal. Mane sends it back in. It wasn't a masterpiece this time. And I reckon with 11 men on the pitch, you know, we could win this tie with 10 on the pitch. It's looking a lot trickier. We've got a corner again. Hopefully we're not going to get countered on. Let's send the ball in. We've got the ball back to Chan. He is very, very tired. And Delmar has had an effort. I'm not sure that was really worthy of a highlight. And now we're at half time in extra time. We're going to see whether there's anything we can do tactically, because we've got 15 minutes to go, maybe even to try and hold on. I think we're looking at penalty kicks. Okay, the final 15 minutes of extra time are underway. We could have won this game late in normal time. We could have won this game in the first half of extra time. And we have missed the chances that we've been gifted. And you always fear that that is going to come back and haunt you. Those match stats are pretty even, you know. But we've got defending to do. We've got 9 minutes to go. They've got the ball on the edge of our box. They could be dangerous from this kind of range. We've charged it down. And Benny Yedder, playing as this auxiliary right wing back, has managed to do a pretty decent job. Rashford-esque playing out there at right back. And we have got the ball again. We've got 7 minutes left. We've got the ball to Giaria. Larsen Pleem, take two. This time, Larsen Pleem tucks it away. Panic stations, everybody, because now we've got 6 minutes to try and hold on. And we've got a striker playing as right wing back. This could mean We might need to make a couple of little tweaks. Thank goodness Lars and Pleem tucked this one away. Give me a moment. I need to have a little snoop around in the tactics. Okay, we're back underway. I could desperately do with two or three more substitutes to bring on. And we're back in the highlight straight away. We're very deep in our own half. We've flung a ball forward, but we've returned it straight to Valencia. If they score, by the way, they're going to be through on the away goals. We've charged it down. And they've got the ball back again. They've sent one in. We've headed it clear again, but there's nobody there for us. We are running on empty all over the pitch. We need to try and just hold on. They've struck a post. I think Van der Heijden was offside, and now we're looking at 118 minutes. We've got a free kick. I was going to try and budge a bit more time wasting on. Let's see how this goes. Just kick it over the bar. Don't give it to their keeper. Now he's going to be able to send it forward. We're going to... Oh, we still couldn't get the old time wasting going. Banze is through. Oh, it's a heartbreaker. What happened? It counted. Where was the replay? There was no replay, but it... Did it count? Did it not count? What happened? The score still says 2-1. Was it offside? I think it was offside. They're showing it now. He was offside. I thought we were out for a moment there. The replay didn't come straight away. Now let's pause the game. We're on 120 minutes. We're going to get the shout. No, we're not going to dabble with the shouts. Instead, let's get into the time waste, and we're going to go lower tempo, playing for set pieces, more time wasting. Let's bring down the line of engagement. And let's see if we can hold out for 59 seconds. We've got a free kick. I thought when there was no replay, I thought that that goal had counted. Lars and Pleem's through, though. They think it's all over. It could have been. If he hadn't slashed yet another effort wide, how wasteful has he been since he came on? I guess we're praising him because he did score one goal for us. But now we've got a final bit of defending to do. We're over the 1 minute of added time, by the way. Where's the referee getting this from? Somebody win us the ball back and just clear it up the pitch. Don't give them a corner. That's the game, the referee says. God, when they scored that disallowed goal, I thought that one had counted. I thought we were out, but we're through. Ladies and gentlemen, we are through. People had written us off today. The boys have got through. And we are into the last eight of the Champions League. I didn't think we'd be able to get past Valencia, if I am honest. And when we went down to 10 men, I thought the jig was up. And when they scored that disallowed goal late on, well, I really did think that we were in trouble. But we've managed to squeeze ourselves through. Now, this means that we are going to be one of the last eight remaining clubs in the Champions League. There's going to be some big teams still left in it. Spurs have got past Juventus. Bayern have beaten Liverpool. Madrid have beaten Dortmund. And then there's some huge sides that are still going to play their second leg, such as Barca, Inter, Atletico Madrid. We're going to get a giant of European football in the last eight. But reaching the quarterfinals of the Champions League was not something that was on our radar this soon. Into our FM21 redemption, we're going to be back for our next episode where we're going to be playing that last eight tie.